My name is Patrick O'Halloran, your friendly neighborhood solutions architect at WhereScape. I'm here today to talk about the scheduler available with Red 10, WhereScape's data warehouse automation tool. First, let me talk in general terms about the scheduler. We use an open source scheduler called Azkaban. At a basic level, Azkaban consists of a scheduler and then one or more executors. The scheduler pulls a database repository to see if there's any new or existing jobs that should be run, then pushes the job out to the executors. The scheduler, as well as the executors, can be installed as a Windows service or a Linux cron job. I've got all these objects here in my dimensional model. I've got some load tables to get data from a source system. I've got stage tables to do transforms. Then I've got some facts and dimensions here. Let's say I want to create a job to repopulate this dimension. I can go here. I can look at my track back diagram, which shows me a data lineage of this. Fairly straightforward. Dimension comes from stage table, comes from load table, comes from source system. But then I can say, okay, let's create a job that populates that dimension. I've got some options here on frequency, how often I want to run this, when I want to run this, or whether I just want to run it ad hoc. Maximum threads if I want to do some parallelization. I've got the ability here to run commands during success or commands during failure. Maybe I want to send messages or emails if this job runs or fails. And after that, I've got the tasks associated with this job. This one's, as I said, straightforward dimension. We'll load the load tables, we'll load the stage tables, and then we'll produce the dimension. If I need to, I can add my own steps in here. I can call scripts. Pretty much anything I can do in a script, I can add here. Maybe I want to send messages, maybe I want to do data validation, log something to another file. I can certainly add that as my own tasks. Once I've done that, I've got my job. I can look here, it's been published. Here's my new job. I can right click here and say start the job. Scheduler sees it, sends it off to an executor. I can look here and see that it's running. And it has completed. And now if I go back to my tab, right click on products, and click on display data, there is all the data for my dimension. So let's say I want to do something a little more complicated. I've got my entire project here. A project is a group of objects. I can right click on the project and say build job. Same thing, I've got the same options here about the frequency, the parallelization, what I want to do on success or failure. I'll just click OK on there. And there's a lot more jobs here. I can see the 1010s are going to run in parallel, the 1020s in parallel, the 1030s and 40s and 50s in parallel. And WhereScape is smart enough that it knows that it needs to run these load tables before these stage tables and populate these dimensions while it runs these load tables, stage tables, and dimensions and facts. So just like the other example, I'll click here. I'll look and see if here's my new job for populating my entire warehouse. I will start it. I will refresh this. The scheduler picks this up, sees that it's an active job, sends it off to an executor, and I can see parallelization, that it's running through, getting load tables, getting stage tables. And pretty soon, it's going to finish up the entire star schema. So there, I created a job that populated my star schema, I executed it, and I've got refreshed data in all my facts and dimensions. Now in this example, everything worked, but let's suppose something happened. And I look here and looked at my job and saw that maybe there were some errors. What can I do to troubleshoot? We've got audit trails, detail logs. I can look and see all the individual steps. These all point to line numbers in a script. If I had my own custom built script, I've got processes there where I can output text, and that'll get captured here as well. So if I do have any problems, any errors, I can very quickly troubleshoot down to the line level in my scripts to figure out what's going on and work from there. One of the cool features about jobs is tags. If I right click here and say edit job, I've got a field here called scheduler tags. That's just basically a freeform text that I can put in, or a list of texts that identify aspects of this job. I can also associate those tags with certain executors. So maybe I have particular ones that only run into Windows, only run into Unix. Maybe I've got an Oracle server and I want my unload process to run on that server. I can put an execute error on there with a specific tag and use it. The idea of scheduler tags is that I can decide which executors get to run which jobs. Maybe I've got something outside a firewall. I've got a REST API and I need to reach out to the web and pull back data, but we've got very strict firewall rules. I can create an executor outside of the firewall with a specific tag on it. All of my REST API loads can then work through that specific executor, and I've narrowed down the need to really open up that firewall. Azkaban is a web-based scheduler. I can access it through the web. It's running locally on my computer right now on port 8082, but obviously that's all configurable. I can look here and see the jobs. I can see the various tasks that are associated with them. I can look and see the executions. I can restart jobs. I can troubleshoot them here as well. There's a lot of things I can do in here without having to have access to Red. So if I have a data ops team or a DevOps team and they're needing to run schedules, they're needing to run jobs, they're needing to check statuses, they're needing to check throughputs and things like that, they can reach it through the web interface. Now I access this via Red, our builder tool. So it already had the login ID. If I access this directly without going through Red, I would have to log in first of all. So again, everything in the scheduler is available outside of Red, available to anyone who's got access to the web server and has credentials to log in. Another nice feature of WhereScape Red Scheduler is that you can kick off jobs through a CLI. So if you're already using an enterprise scheduler and your DevOps team is used to using that, you can use the CLI to kick off WhereScape jobs through your own enterprise scheduler. We'll give return back statuses and such, and plus you've still got all the features and functions of the Red Scheduler. So the scheduler is pretty cool. You can create jobs, you can create tasks, you can add your own custom tasks and custom scripts. You can have multiple executors out there running these jobs that keep your warehouse up to date, and you can distribute them across servers as you see fit. If you want more information, feel free to contact us. We are at WhereScape.com. Thank you.